When students walked into my classroom and found science listed on the daily schedule, their faces would light up and their energy levels went up too. My students loved hands-on activities in science, and they begged for lessons that allowed them to learn in a kinesthetic way, making predictions and investigating. The problem was that with our lengthy math and reading blocks, science was one of those subjects that sometimes got pushed off, or its allotted time was cut way down. Because of this, I was always looking for opportunities to blend science into other subjects. In today's video, I'm going to share with you some activities that you can do in your classroom to blend science into your math block. On to the episode. What's kicking, educational rock stars? Welcome back to my channel. I'm your host, Farrah, from Farrah Henley Education, where I strive to bring you actionable tips, strategies, and simple systems to take back into your classroom to make your teacher life a little easier. Now, if this is your first time joining me here on the channel, be sure you hit that like and that subscribe button and click that bell so that you get notified when I go live or upload a new video here on the channel. I'm so excited to continue kind of the discussion from last week where I shared with you how to incorporate social studies content into your reading block. And we're going to stick with that theme, and we are going to be jumping into science and how you can kind of integrate science into your math block. And for similar reasons that I spoke of last week with regard to social studies and reading, you might want to do this in your classroom. Today, I am going to share with you some of our favorite activities for integrating science into math. But before I do that, I want you to drop down in the comments, are there any favorite science activities that you've done during a math lesson? And I would love to know those. So drop those down, share those with the audience, let them know. Because listen, I tell y'all this all the time, the best professional development is the teacher next door, and sharing our ideas is the way that we get more things done, because sometimes we just can't get out of our own head and come up with ideas for things. So share those ideas for science activities that you could do in math. And I'm gonna share four of my favorite ones here right now. So, all right. So my first way that I loved to integrate science into math was get cooking. Yes. Cook in your classroom. Do you cook in your classroom? Now, I realize that there may be some restrictions, some schools. I've talked to teachers in the past who maybe had some restrictions where they couldn't do cooking in their classroom, but I was never in a situation where I couldn't do some cooking in my classroom, and I had a very simple little convection or the toaster oven type things that I would bring into my classroom. Obviously, I was the only one doing anything with it, but I was able to cook. And one of my absolute favorite things to do was to cook cookies with my students. Now, you might think, you're cooking cookies. How is this a science activity and math activity? Well, first of all, you can talk about the changes in matter because you're taking dry physical ingredients and then liquids, and you're putting them together and they are changing their forms and the forms of matter. Then you are going to be cooking them. So there's going to be evaporation happening and again, a change in matter. You can also talk about the steam that's coming off of them and how that is the water turning into a gas. And then you can talk about the measurements. Obviously, this is where the math skills come in. You've got to measure ingredients. You've got to set the temperature and make sure the temperature is correct inside the oven. Then graphing. One of our favorite ways to do it was to make the cookies different shapes and then graph the different shapes that came out. Once the cookies were done, we would make graphs. And then, of course, learning shapes. If you're doing this with younger students who are learning shapes, maybe down in kindergarten, you could talk about the different shapes, bring in cookie cutters and things like that and talk about shapes. So there's all different kinds of ways, but really cooking anything in your classroom, you can incorporate so many science skills and math skills together and do it at the same time so that you can have a little bit extra time, because something like cooking is going to take quite a bit more time than you probably even have in a normal science block. I don't know about you, but normally my science time was around 30 minutes. Obviously, cooking was going to take a little longer. So if I pulled math and science together, we were able to cook in our classroom. Now, the second thing that I loved to do was really the water cycle, life cycles, anything like that. But talking about those water cycles and life cycles and talking about measurement, temperatures, graphing, specifically with the water cycle, you're going to be talking about evaporation. Obviously, any of these things that are going on, you are going to be taking and doing predictions and doing some investigating into these water cycle and the life cycle. But your math skills, like being able to read a thermometer, being able to read a ruler, fractions, any number of math skills can be used when they're doing these different activities in science. But again, sometimes our science block is so short, or we need to teach measurement and fractions and temperature and things like that, and graphing, but we don't have enough time we've got to focus on those and we end up not doing math. So bring some of those typical science skills into your math block. Now, probably one of my very favorite activities was build it, and literally build anything. Again, you're talking measurement, area, angles. And then for science, anytime they're building things, for example, my students loved our activity where they built a roller coaster, and we used all kinds of different STEM supplies, such as paper towel rolls and tape and toothpicks and popsicle sticks, any pipe cleaner, things like that. But being able to build one and then use things like the Hot Wheel cars and talking about inertia and force and motion, and then being able to measure where those angles were and graphing the different outcomes as they were investigating and making their predictions. This is all blending that math, those math skills and science concepts into one, and you're able to hit all of those skills and all of those standards in your classroom. The fourth way, I don't know that I did this every single year. I did it a lot. But we always had some sort of space unit, or we talked about the planets. Anybody else really sad when Pluto wasn't a planet anymore? And then it was, and I haven't taught the planets in so long, so I would have to go look it up, to be honest with you. But talking about the planets, and of course, my students always loved building the models of the planets and things like that. But specifically, when we would explore the planets and we would talk about their different temperatures, and we would talk about the diameter of each planet or the circumference around the planets, and then we would find the area. And it was just so much fun to bring those math skills when we were talking about and exploring the differences between the planets, graphing the planets, the information we gathered in our investigations for the planets. And it was also amazing to watch their predictions, because a lot of students would predict that certain planets would be colder or hotter, and then we would start doing the research, and we would find those temperatures of those planets. Now, obviously, we're not going to go to Jupiter and take a measurement of the temperature. That's already been done for us. But being able to graph those temperatures on a line plot and be able to see the difference in the temperatures of the planets, that's a way you can bring science and math together. Now, these are just a few ways that you can blend science into math and give your students some real world experience putting those math skills to work. And the next time you plan a math lesson, try to come up with some scientific ways to have them practice those math skills that isn't just rote pencil and paper practice. Now, if you're looking for more tips, strategies, and simple systems to take back into your classroom to make your teacher life easier, check out the videos on your screen. Thanks for watching, and keep being an educational rock star.